Well, hi there, it's Scott Duffy from getcloudskills.com. And in this video, we're going to talk about the latest announced AI-900 exam changes from Microsoft. These changes go into effect on April 29th, 2022. Now we can see on screen that Microsoft has actually moved the weightings of the various exam objectives around. So the first objective says describe AI workloads, and that has actually been increased by 5% from 15 to 20 up to 2025. The second objective has to do with the fundamental principles of machine learning on Azure, and that's actually been reduced. It was 30 to 35, which is quite high, and is now down to 25 and 30. Computer vision has pretty much remained unchanged. The most significant change is that they've removed the last requirement, which is conversational AI, and basically merged it with the natural language processing workloads. And so they bumped up the NLP requirement from 15 to 20 to 25 to 30, but it does contain both requirements in one. So let's talk about the individual changes. So in the first objective, describe AI workloads, what they've done is they've removed a couple of minor requirements having to do with identify prediction and forecasting workloads and identify conversational AI workloads. All of the rest pretty much have remained the same, and we can see the new requirements on screen. For the second objective, fundamental principles of machine learning on Azure, they've removed the core task in creating a machine learning solution. Now, this is pretty significant because this is an implementation detail. These are how you go about creating and training a model within Azure and testing that model. And so you don't need to know the steps for the actual creating of a model within Azure. The third objective having to do with computer vision, totally the same. Not a thing about it's changed. Even the percentage is the same. The fourth objective, as I said, was basically merged of the conversational AI and natural language processing into one objective. The title still says natural language processing. It's worth 25 to 30% now. What they've done, removed a couple of details in terms of text analytics services, and they've added the things about bots and Azure bot service that was in the conversational AI section. The rest of the conversational AI stuff has been removed. So overall, this has just been a tweak to the requirements. I think they're largely the same, 90% the same or 95% the same, but the most significant removal was the steps to train and test a model, which is more of an advanced topic. So they're focusing on introductory topics in my view. There is a few of the conversational AI stuff removed, most so that they've even merged it with the NLP section. So less about the Q&A maker and other types of bots. There's less implementation knowledge required for this exam. So I view them as being subtle changes. If you're currently studying for this exam, I wouldn't let it affect it. I'm not going to wait until the end of April or early May to take this test. If you're in the middle of studying, just continue. If you're planning to take the test in the next week or two, just continue. Maybe if you were planning it for the end of April, that might make it a tiny bit easier to study if you wait until May. But to me, my view is that it's just a refinement of the objectives to a small degree. I do have a course on AI 900 exam. The URL is on screen, sjd.ca/AI900. You'll get a discount on my course on Udemy. It is the best course on the topic in my view. And so please go ahead and check it out. I appreciate it if you would give me a like on this video. It would help the YouTube algorithm, and consider subscribing to this channel so that you get all of the latest changes to the Microsoft Azure exams in your YouTube feed. So thanks a lot, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.